I am not a champion sketchbook artist, but it is something that I still do on a regular basis. I'm the kind of person that fills half of a sketchbook and then moves on to the next one. This sketchbook is one that I started when I first got into art school. The way that I filled it was I turned to just a random page and put stuff in it. This was an idea I had for a painting in class. 6 months later on the beach, I was drawing people on the beach. And then there are to-do lists and drawings of hands, moody teenager diary stuff, except it wasn't when I was a teenager, it was in my 20s. Lots of pictures of David Bowie, quotes that I liked. It's just got everything. It's like my brain. It's one big dump. I guess the one reason I like this sketchbook is because it has reference photos of images by other artists that I really like, which is not something I've done with other sketchbooks. I was trying to make a new color blue out of ultramarine blue. Someone gave me this pigment. This is one of my most prized possessions. This marks a huge transition in my work because this is mostly filled with actual drawings and marker drawings that I turn into paintings later. When I'm painting, I'm working between drawings that are in the sketchbook and the sketchbook. This sketchbook is much more practice-based and school-based. So I've got critiques in here, journal entries about my studio practice, about how I deal with failure, color palettes for paintings. A lot of these paintings didn't end up happening. I do thumbnails for my body paintings. I found that super important, even more important than doing thumbnails for regular paintings on canvas. Having an idea of what I want my body painting to turn out like has been really important. And then this page has another one, and I would usually do several ideas for body painting at a time so that I could just execute them all in one go when I have my models. Ideas for installations. This is mostly an idea book. I want to come back to this book and to the ideas in there. I was doing all sorts of different things that I don't do now. Most of my stuff is very color and image based. A lot of this had more to do with materials and different formats of working. So this painting ended up being one of my finals, and I only did one thumbnail. I was bad with thumbnails. This was a doodle during class, and I did the back of the doodle too. This red one was one that I started after I transferred. It was my second 2 years in school. It was during my red year, that's why it's red. I had several history classes. It's got different concepts and stuff, but it's mostly writing and critiques. This sketchbook is when I first started using markers, which marks, no pun intended, a huge transition in my work. It made it so much better. It streamlined my process. It got me more focused on color, which was the thing that I really liked to begin with. It got me out of my head. It was a place where I could just go and draw things and not write about everything I was worried about. So everything became a lot more work-based, like studio-based finally. And I've turned a lot of these drawings into paintings later on. I also include some of my stuff for printmaking in here. I do lino cuts and eraser carvings, so these are all my tests for that. I've turned this one into a painting, and this one into a painting. These are my thumbnails. My thumbnails became really huge. This was a collaboration with a little girl in church, because I can't stand just listening. I have to be drawing, and she felt the same way. Using the markers has made me really appreciative of sketchbooking. I don't think I was sketchbooking in the right way before. And now I'm doing it in a way that I really capture information that I want. Testing out different color palettes. This is one of my favorite color palettes, especially with the black marker in there. Some of these things end up paintings. My idea is that I want almost all of them to end up paintings, but it's never gonna get there. This is my most drawing from life book, I think, out of all the ones I have. So this was like my brother's graduation. This was of one of the jackets that I own. Turning this one to a painting of a skier. And these are different color palettes that I'm using or thinking about using. I drew this from life and then I worked from the sketch. Mostly I just wanted to capture all the different patterns that were happening, like the several different types of leaves that were going across the ceiling and how there were speckles on some of the leaves and like these kind of whooshy leaves. Sometimes it's just like a I hate the world kind of thing. I have bad drawing days a lot. Or sometimes it's just like a marker test out area. This is my list of all my paintings that I need to finish that I want to do. I always forget the names of artists, so I keep lists of them so I can go back and look at them. I got commission for a couple birds that were like feeding each other, so I did thumbnails for this one. I've got how I want the composition, trying to fit everything in, and then how I want the colors to look. This is one that I did at Professor Liu's house, of some eels coming out of a rug. It's from life. Oh, this was a really beautiful theater that I was at in New York. I had to at least draw it. Couldn't take a picture of it. Most of my sketchbooks that I have, oh wait, here?
Well, not that far.
Right here, out here? Okay.